Joey! let's see. Okay, this is me, this is me. Down right here. Striker. Okay. All right, I think that might be, we might be having room for right now. Now again, you will have an opportunity to be hypnotized in the audience. You will have an opportunity to come up on stage. I'll explain how that works in just a minute. All right, for those people on stage, I have three things we're going to tell you very quickly. Number one, when you do get hypnotized, you do not get zapped or put to sleep, which means you'll continue to be aware of everything going on around you, but you're going to be so mellowed out, who cares? It feels good. But again, I will not allow you to go beyond a certain point. Number two, I've never had a person one-on-one who could not be hypnotized. If I were to spend 20 minutes here this morning, all of you would be great subjects, but during the program, I only use about a five-minute process. So if you don't go down deeply enough, and I like to send any of you back to the audience, don't be offended, think anything's wrong with you, or you can't be hypnotized. Something happened to bug your concentration when I tried a little bit too hard. And number three, this is very important. Once your eyes have closed, do not open up your eyes again until I tell you to. Occasionally, someone opens up their eyes before I finish the process, it'll break your concentration. Has anyone up here been hypnotized before? Anyone stays right down here? Let's see. Can you trade places with him for just a second? Can you come up here? Can you trade places? You were hypnotized before, pretty good feeling?
What?
Was it a pretty good feeling?
Sure.
Alright, what I'm going to do with this gentleman, I'm going to re-hypnotize him in about 3 seconds, just to show you how quickly a person can be hypnotized who's been hypnotized before. At the deep level, they never ever lose the ability to render that level over again. Now, for those of you who have never been hypnotized, initially it's going to take longer this evening, but by the end of the program, you'll be able to be re-hypnotized just as quickly as he is right now. Now, let me show you what I'm talking about. As you can tell, this dude is relaxed, okay? Now, he's not asleep, he's not unconscious, and he's not down under. He's just chilling out in a big way. All right, I'm going to give a couple suggestions very quickly. First of all, so your motivation to study during the remainder of this school year will be greater than it's ever been before. Your concentration will be more intense, your comprehension more complete. Anything you read or hear, you're not going to be able to retain, but you will be able to recall anytime you want, easily, effortlessly, automatically. Now, you can remember things, you can also forget things. Let's say you want to block out an unpleasant memory from the past, you can do that too. For instance, I remember the back of his neck right now, I'm erasing something that's rather important to him, I'm now erasing his name. Name is now gone. Now, in a little while, when he opens up his eyes and I ask him his name, he's going to think this is the most bizarre thing that's ever happened. He's going to know he had a name when he came up here, but he won't be able to say his name until I snap my fingers. When I snap my fingers, it will come back instantaneously. On the count of three, sir, you look your eyes feeling great in every way, wondering why your hat's lying on the floor, and you'll not be able to say your name, sir, until I snap my fingers. One, two, three, open up your eyes. How you doing? Okay? Nice hat, by the way. Listen, I always like to remember who I work with. What's your name again? Another tough morning in Spencer. We've all had them, people. We've all had these mornings. And what is it?
Shane.
Yes, good. Give him a big hand. Shane, yes. You know that. Now, there aren't many ways to hypnotize people. What we're going to be using tonight is an eye fixation point, which is this red light. Now, there's nothing magic about light, but it helps focus your concentration for a period of time. And by the way, it is possible to be hypnotized in the audience. Earlier this morning, about midnight, we did a program down in Marshalltown. We had about a similar number of people in the audience. Besides the people that got hypnotized on stage, we had over 40 people get hypnotized in the audience. They were dropping light flies all over the place. So if you're in the audience this morning and you like to be hypnotized, watch the light, listen to my voice. If you don't want to be hypnotized, people, don't watch the light. All right, it's as simple as that. If you do get hypnotized in the audience, I might tap you on the shoulder. Ask you like to join us on stage. If at that point in time you don't want to, you would automatically come out of hypnosis. On the other hand, if you'd like to, you come up, you sit down, you very easily re-enter the hypnotic state. Now, once I have all of my subjects, if there is anyone in the audience still hypnotized, I'll make sure you come out of hypnosis at that point. There won't be people leaving the building a little bit later this morning going, oh, that will not happen, all right, I guarantee it. All right, let's see, I'm going to move on. You got me to come over here, and sir, why don't you go down there and sit down so we can mix the guys and girls a little bit more? Okay, people on stage, I put your feet flat on the floor if they reach. They don't reach as your toes. Put your palms on your knees and sit back so you're as comfortable as possible. Now, people on stage, when I tell you to watch this light right here, it's going to be very important you never take your eyes off the light again. There should be another switch there, so you might have to turn one up. One up, yeah, there you go. All right, people on stage, you can make it. Just a few more inches, a few more steps. That's it. I'm learning how to walk all over again. Yes. Exotic Ryaness right here. There we go. All right. Everyone sits right up in your chairs now. Please flatten the floor. Concentrate on me. I'm going to take you right back down very deeply, very quickly. Concentrate only on me. Listen to my voice. Chair, but any outside laughter applause will take you down even deeper. Let's give some applause, people, and take them way down. It's time to get down, even deeper, faster, fully ready. But in no time, we'll fall off your chair. Bob, if you come out now, people on stage will feel some people behind you, but in no time, we'll bother you in any way. Here's what's going to happen in a minute. For those of you who've never seen a program like this before, I've just moved them into the right brain, which is where hypnosis comes about. Now, the right brain is the center of creativity. The right brain is also where inhibitions are minimized. So if you know some of the people on stage tonight, you know what they're normally like? When they're hypnotized, their behaviors can be enhanced anywhere from 20 to 30 times. That's why you get a lot of creativity, a lot of animation. But just before I do that, I'm going to take a brief present to the audience here. Well, someone has not yet come back from the Twilight Zone. And I got a thing, I'm just going to open her eyes. I have absolutely no idea what she's doing so close to the floor. Want to get your eyes? 1, 2, 3. How you doing?
All right.
Okay, yes. I think we're going to need a couple more spotters. This group's going to get a lot more animated than this. I might need to get a couple more spotters, some a couple more adult spotters up here if you would, because this group will get extremely animated in just a couple minutes. On the count of three, people, the journey bound imagination is going to begin. We're going to take you to a place with absolutely no tension, no tightness, no pressure in any way. As a matter of fact, people are going to be more relaxed than in a long, long time. Now, those of you here last year, there'll be just one similarity here, but it should change completely from there. On the count of three, the lights come on, people. I want you to imagine that you're at Maui, Hawaii. It's going to be a beautiful summer day. You're going to be sitting out on the beach, plenty of sun, plenty of sand, plenty of fun. On the count of three, the lights come on, stretch out in your chair with your eyes closed to feel a few rays of the sun. 1, 2, 3. Just stretch all the way back in those chairs. The more you stretch back, the better you feel. That's in the Virgo's Islands, and sleep. And sleep deep. That's it. Just stretch all the way back. That's it. That's it. Just stretch back in those chairs. But people, don't get your feet on too far. There has been a shark alert. People, watch your feet. Get your hold of chairs, Father. 1, 2, 3. Shark's done. Shark's done. Shark's done. Stretch back out. Shark's done. Shark's done. It's cool. Shark's done. It's cool. That's it. Shark's gone. Stretch back on. It's okay. So shark's gone. That's it. There we go. Stretch right back over that chair. Everyone, hold your right hand straight out in front of you toward me. I'm going to give you some lotion. And super. That's it. Hold your right hand straight out in front of you toward me. People, put the palm upward. I'm going to give each one of you some lotion. Now, when I put the lotion on your hand, you're not using lotion until I tell you to, because this lotion can be used for many things. Don't use it yet, Prince. Those will be like a nice golden tan. will help you out. For those of you who burn rather easily, keep you from burning. Here's some lotion for you. And for those of you who like to tan, it will help you tan. And it'll help you feel good. So on the count of three, anywhere you want to tan, you don't want to burn, you want to feel good, you can put the lotion. One, two, three, go. You can put it anywhere you want. The more you use, the more you tan, the better you feel, the less you burn. That's it, people. The more you use, the more you tan, the better you feel, the less you burn. That's it. There we go. As you use that lotion, you bet. Yes, he's going to feel real good here. Okay, that's it. All right, stretch back out in those chairs, people. Stretch back out in those chairs. It's about 75 degrees right now. As I count up, it's going to begin to get warmer. As it gets warmer, some of those shoes might become a little bit hot. Your feet, guys, some of those shirts might stick to your bodies. As it becomes warmer, if you need to cool yourself off, feel free to do so. And now it's 80 degrees, 85 degrees, 86 degrees, 88 degrees, 89 degrees, people. Cool yourselves off. 90 degrees, it's getting hotter. Take your hands and fan yourselves. Fan yourselves. Fan yourselves. It's getting warmer. 96 degrees. 98 degrees. 100 degrees. It's getting warmer. It's getting warmer here. Fan yourselves. 110 degrees, people. I mean, it is nasty. And now it's 90, 80, 70, 60, 50 degrees, 40 degrees, 30 degrees. There's a cold wind coming in. 20 degrees, you got icicles on your bodies. 10 degrees, you got a warm body next to you. Cuddle up if you want to. Cuddle up if you want to, people. Yes, it is cold. Yes, it is cold. Yes, it is cold. On the count of three, people, don't open up your eyes. You're going to be right back here. Right back here in Spencer. Absolutely no idea why you're doing what you are. On the count of three, you're going to be absolutely amazed. One, two, three. Open up your eyes. Back in Spencer. Give them a big hand as they sit back in their chairs here. Give them a big hand. Hey, yeah. You two know each other pretty well? You two know each other? Yeah, because you just got acquainted, you didn't. Okay, everyone sit straight up again. Put your feet flat on the floor. If you took your shoes off for some reason, slide them underneath your chair. If you took your shoes off, slide them underneath your chair. That's it. And then everyone sit straight up in your chair and watch my hand. I want to ask you a question, people. I do about 400 some programs each year throughout the United States, Canada, and Europe. I'm trying to decide what types of music different people like. Any type of music that you're into, raise your hand. If you're into more than one kind of music, you can raise your hand more than once. How many people here like classical music? All right. Anyone here like jazz, blues, rock and roll music, rap music, country western music, alternative music? Okay, everyone sit straight up again. Watch my hand as it moves toward the ceiling. Each time I drop my hand and say sleep, just allow your eyes to go closed to drift right back down without falling off your chair. On the count of three. One, two, three. Down deep. Each time deeper and faster. That's all right, so you can go back. Thanks a lot. Give a big hand. Here's it for a little bit. Thanks a lot, dude. We'll get you next time. That's it. On the count of three, you stretch back out of your chairs with your eyes closed. One, two, three. Stretch right back out with your eyes closed, people. All right, you're still here on Maui. People, let me tell you something. We have a brand new prototype roller coaster. Let me tell you something about this roller coaster, people. It has speeds in excess of 950 miles an hour. It has the sharpest corners, the deepest drops, the most awesome upside-down maneuvers that everyone's experienced. Two things about this roller coaster. Number one, you cannot fall off. And number two, you cannot get sick on this roller coaster. You people in the front will appreciate that a great deal. On the count of three, people, instead of opening up your eyes, when you do, you're going to be ready for the ride of your life. Now, people in the audience, from this point forward, anytime they open up their eyes, they will be in a waking state of hypnosis. They'll be able to see everything, but they'll be in their own little fantasy where they're ready to take one heck of a trip. On the count of three, people, you're going to sit up, open up your eyes, and put your safety harnesses on. One, two, three. Open up your eyes, people, get your safety harnesses on very quickly. Reach down by your feet, pick up your helmet. Kick your helmet up, people. Put that helmet on top of your head, pass the strap underneath your chin, and then hold on the bar in front of you with both hands. Hold it too tight. Sir, this car's out of commission. Take your safety harness off, sir. We got to move you to another car. That car's broke. Take your safety harness off, sir. There we go. Come right down here, sir. Climbing this car right over here. Yes. Yeah, that one was broke. You're going to run up into the truck. All right. Yeah, there we go. All right. That's it. Like to have. All right, there we go. Okay, everyone hold on tight. On the count of three, you're going to bang shot out of the tube at 480 miles an hour. You're going to feel the G-force hit you right in the face. One, two, three. Just about to the top. On the count of three, you're going to scare the heck out of me. can't fall off your chair. One, two, three, down! And now you're going back up. Back up, and now you're going straight up. Straight up. Look at the size of this mother. You're going straight up. Wait a minute, people. I don't know if it's going to make it. Help it out. Push it. Push it. People, you're on top. Don't move. People, don't move. We got a major problem. People, open up your eyes and look down. Look down, people. One of the rails came off. One of the rails came off. Women, don't panic. Don't panic. Don't panic. Keep calm. Keep calm. Don't move too quickly. Don't panic. Keep calm. Keep calm. People, look up overhead. Look up overhead. There's an Iowa National Guard helicopter. Don't move too quickly. It's got some safety lines hanging down. Don't move too much. Very slowly take off your seat harnesses. Very slowly take off your safety harnesses and then reach up slowly toward the helicopter. Don't move too fast. Don't move too fast. That's it. Reach straight up. Reach straight up. That's it. Look up. See where it's at? Open up your eyes. Look up. That's it. Wait a minute. The helicopter's moving off to the right. The helicopter's moving off. Straight back up. Straight back up, people. Straight back up. We got another way to get to water. Don't panic. Don't panic, people. On the count of three, I want you to stand up with your eyes open. Don't move your feet, but slowly flap your arms. One, two, three. Stand up, people, and flap your arms. Hey, you're flying. You're flying. Hey, look around. Hey, this is me. Watch out. Don't bother your neighbor now. Hey, look around. You're flying. See the birds? See the clouds? Wait a minute. Here comes a little flying jet. Keep flying. Keep flying. You're okay. You're okay. Keep flying. And all of a sudden, you realize, people, you're a magnificent flock of ducks. A proud flock of ducks. Flying ever so gracefully across the ocean of blue. Just flying along, what a great day. That's it, you're flying along, but all of a sudden you look down, you see a hunter down there, and you hear a, don't panic, keep flying. Keep flying, keep flying, don't panic. Lead duck, out this way, lead duck, out this way. Here we go, lead duck, that's it. Stand right there, lead duck, don't move your feet, plant yourself. On the count of three, ducks, I want you to slowly get in formation behind the lead duck. One, two, three, get in formation behind the lead duck. That's it, there we go. That's it, there we go. That's it. And that lead duck is a proud duck. Look at the way he holds up that head. He is one proud macho male duck. You talk about a leader of the flock. That's it. A leader of the flock. By the way, Shannon, turn the rest of the stage lights. We've got some off at the front. Yeah, one of the switches turned down. Flying along. There we go. On the count of three, lead duck, you're going to make a slow right hand point out over your feet. The other ducks will follow you. One, two, three. And faster, and faster. And now you've been flying for 29 hours. You are getting that tired. Those wings are getting tired. Those little tailfins are getting heavy. You're getting darn hungry. The lead duck looks down over Southern Iowa and spots a cornfield. Point out the cornfield, lead duck. Point it out. Point it out. There it is. There it is. You got a visual sighting at 5 o'clock. All right, on the count of three, ducks are going to start gliding down, but you won't land unless I tell you to. One, two, three. One, two, three, and now this is good corn. This is great corn. This is some of the best corn you've ever had in your entire life. You talk about some good corn, you're going to get into this big time. And now one, two, three, you realize what you're doing. Give a big hand to get back up there, cherry people. Give a big hand. We're going to get to the bottom of this. We've got absolutely no idea what's going on here. Let me get back up in your chair. Let me get to the bottom of this entire episode. Yes. Everyone get right back up in your chair. We'll find out what's going on here in a minute. I say yes. Yes, just sit right back down. Sometimes you get out of order. That's it. That's okay. So you can write right down that end chair. There we go. Which camp is this? There we go. There we go. All right, everyone, sit straight up again. Feet flat on the floor, palms on your knees. As it sits back, you're as comfortable as possible with where you're at. All right, that's it. Could you help me out for just a second, please? Can you come in right here? Come right over here, please. Turn around, face the group. Put your right arm up in the air. Extend the index finger right here. I want everyone to look at this finger. This finger's now becoming magic. The next time she touches your nose with that finger, you're gonna go right back down in hypnosis without falling off your chair. Touch his nose down there in the very tip, real light, right in the end. Real light, right in the tip, he'll go right out. Yes. Oh. You're good. Stuck. Uh-oh. Hey, wanna do it again? Hey, wanna do it to all of them? Go pretty fast to touch the very light. Go fast to touch the light. Here we go, that's it. There we go, there we go. Good, just touch it, don't pick it, go fast. That's it, that's it. That's it. Ooh, I'm just hurt. Don't worry, I'll get hurt. Okay. She's a server, she doesn't care. Oh, give her a big hand, she is good, yes. Come back over here, sit down. Oops. Tell you what, could I just have you hold your right hand? Could you just hold your right arm in front of me? You know how small that finger is compared to the arm? Do you think that finger could touch your nose if you didn't want it to? That could happen, could it? You can stop it, can't you? Watch that finger real close. On the count of three, that finger's gonna become magic. It's gonna start moving toward your nose, but you're gonna fight it with every ounce of your strength. On the second count, it's gonna touch your nose, and you're gonna go down deep. One, two, three. That finger will down deep, yes. Real strong. Give a big hand, people. Great group up here. And there is, sometimes the person has a tendency to have the concentration broken for just a second. There's one person had the concentration broken just now. I'm gonna send that person back, he's gonna have a great time in the audience. One, two, three. Open up your eyes, sir. Give him a big hand. Thank you very much for coming up, sir. Just got these concentration over here. Thanks a lot, dude. On the count of three, people are going to hear some music come on. When you hear the music come on, you're going to realize you're very gifted, talented dancers. And you are here tonight for the finals of the National Dance Competition. Now, people, let me tell you about this dance competition. It's a very unique dance competition, which means the more unique you are, the more different you are, the more creative you are, the better chance you have of winning this dance competition. When the music comes on, people, you remain seated. But when I say dance, people, you'll stand up, open up your eyes, begin to dance slowly in front of your chair, and then one at a time, I'll give you 5 seconds to strut your stuff. Remain seated until I say dance fever. What? Remember, when the music comes on, when I say dance fever, you'll stand up, open up your eyes, and begin to dance. On the count of three. One. Everyone, so I'm gonna let you draw on the count of three. You and me. Be ready, dude. The two of us. I think I used a little bitty one in her. And use more power, maybe. And then you sit up straight. You too. This is now a laser machine gun. Hey, give them a big hand as they go way down. On the count of three, sit back up with your eyes closed, feeling comfortable. One, two, three. Sit back up with your eyes closed, feeling very comfortable indeed. As it eases down a little bit deeper, faster, feeling a little bit better. As it, here we go. As it, feeling good. As you listen to my voice. On the count of three. On the count of three, the gentleman touching his stand-up moment resigns. When he does, he's going to realize he's no longer from the planet Earth. He's going to be from the planet Mars. He's going to understand English language, but he's only going to speak in the Martian tongue. Now, people may ask, watch the look at his face when he opens up his eyes and sees all you bizarre looking earthlings sitting out there. One, two, three, open your eyes, sir. Sir, stand up here. They can't get you. Stand up here, sir. Gravitational pull's a little different. Be careful. Yes, okay, you can do it, sir. Yes, yes, here we go. Yes. Just try to slide down this way a little bit, sir. Okay. Now, sir, I understand you're from the planet Mars. You know the English language, but you only speak in the Martian tongue. In your native tongue, sir, what part of Mars are you from? Wait a minute, sir, I don't understand. I need to get an interpreter. I don't understand. I have to get an interpreter here. All right. Let me see. There's got to be an interpreter here somewhere. I saw one earlier. On the count of three, the gentleman touching over his eyes has been a very famous Martian interpreter. One, two, three, open up your eyes. Are you a Martian interpreter, sir?
Yeah.
Okay, stand up here. Stand up here. Sir, right out here. Can you tell me how many years of practice and study and training has taken you to become very good in the Martian language? About how long would you say?
67.
Really? Wow, 67 is pretty good. Are there still 7 dialects in Mars, or has that been changed? Are there more than 7, fewer than 7, or still 7?
8.
8, okay. Mr. Martian, can you come down here? You can open your eyes again, Mr. Martian. This gentleman's from Mars, I understand English not very well. I'm going to ask you a question in English. You ask him in Martian. When he gives you an answer in Martian, you tell us in English what he said, all right? And you got to speak up. We are on national TV. See the camera over there? This is for a documentary. Look good. Look sharp. Okay. All right. Ask him what part of Mars he's from and tell him to speak up. That's what he told me, too. What part is he from, sir?
The north.
Oh, the north side. Oh, okay. North side. But he asked my guy from the north side of Mars all the way down here to Earth and tell him to give us as much information as he can. How did he get down here?
I didn't understand it.
Oh, well, tell him to repeat it. How do you get down here, sir?
He walked.
Wow, well, fuck, no way he's tired. Well, as he's down in Mars, ask him as he looks out in the audience, what do you like best about this planet?
I don't know what I'm going to
do. I don't know what I'm going to do.
What is it like?
The women.
Some signs are universal. Let's remember, ladies on Mars, basically different from ladies on Earth.
내가 데리고 나가도
저는 이미 등장하나봐
We're on national TV, sir. How do they basically differ?
Figures.
Okay, oh, okay, yeah. Oh. Let's get hot in here. Okay. Ask him if there's anything I can do before he gets back to Mars.
Negative, no, no, no.
Yeah, but I'm taking a lot.
What's he gonna do?
Marry an American woman.
Oh, marry an American woman, huh? Give a Martian interpreter big hand as they go back to the lobby. Well, that must have been a long walk. And a lot of Ben Gay. Watch my finger, Mr. Martian, and... I'm going to use a boomerang next time I interpret. Watch this boomerang, so I throw it on the ice. Watch this, watch this, watch this. Let me show you what I'm talking about. On the count of three, the gentleman takes off his eyes, and what he does standing in front of him is going to be the most beautiful girl he's ever seen in his entire life. One, two, three. Are you ready, sir? Yes. Stand up here, sir. Sir, she's out from Hollywood looking for a guy who happens to her in a new movie. Would you like to trap for the part?
Sure.
Okay. Put your arms around her, but be gentle. Now, this part calls for a kissing scene. Is that all right? Okay. Now, one thing I should tell you, sir, by the way, you're on national TV again, this first screen. I should tell you, sir, 28 other guys have tried out for this part. When I say go, you only have 5 seconds for trying to do it. 5 seconds. So, technique, style, versatility, very important, but you only have 5 seconds, sir, on the count of three. This is your big opportunity to try to win a major part in any movie. One, two, three, go. Five, four, three, two, one. That's enough? Yeah! How was she?
Good.
Yes! Yes. And boom. Give him a big hand. Nice young man. A very versatile piece of equipment. I really wanted that part, man. Yes, Pete, we do have a very famous singing personality came with us this year. Not too long ago, she got in trouble on David Letterman's show doing some things she shouldn't have done. On the count of three, the person I'm touching will stand up open his eyes, being the one and only Madonna. On the count of three, right here, after Prom 1994, Spencer. One, two, three, up the grass. Here she is, Madonna! Give her a big hand! Right here, yes! Welcome, everybody, Prince. Thank you, yes! Wow, what a pleasure. How you doing, Madonna?
Great.
Good. Madonna, what are you doing here at Spencer Island? Let's talk out. Would you like Madonna to sing a song with some cheer people? What do you think, huh? What do you think?
Sure.
Okay, slide down there, Madonna, get a band. Madonna's here. Madonna's here. Yes. On the count of three, the two people touching will be duo keyboard players. What's your deal with the guys? You two, open up your eyes right here. You two play duo keyboards, is that right? Okay, stand up. They're right here, get situated. You're going to be backing up for Madonna tonight. By the way, how long have the two of you been playing keyboards together to be good enough to back up for a big star like Madonna? How long have you two been working on the keyboards together?
8 years.
8 years, is that about right?
Yeah.
See, it takes a long time to get good. All right, and let's see here. We're going to need to get a couple guitars here, a couple guitars. And on the count of three, first of all, it's going to be a very gifted guitarist. What's the deal with guys? You play guitar? Oh, good, stand up. Here it is. Here's your guitar. There we go, all right. And we're going to need to get some backup tambourinists and dancers.
One, two, three, up.
Guys, you three stand up. We need some backup tambourinists and dancers for Madonna. I'm going to slide that down just a little bit more. Madonna likes a nice balance. You three want to stand up here. Need some backup. And how many tambourines can you handle?
Three.
Three? Really? Wow. What do you feel like? Two in one hand, one in the other? What?
I can't feel my
strap
on.
One around your knee. Very good idea. Madonna, can I have you slide back down there? Sorry to keep bothering like this. Excellent personal work, but yes. How many do you want?
Two.
Two. You got the small ones or the big ones?
Big.
Okay. And how many do you like?
Two.
Two. You might want to move them just spread out a little bit. These big ones, they get in the way a lot of times. Good people. Alright, and listen, we kind of need to get a drummer. Sorry, Adam. Need to get a drummer here. Adam, listen here. What did they open drives? You play drums?
No.
Oh, good. Here's some drumsticks. Practice, try them out, so we see how they work out. Oh, good. Give him a big hand. He's good. He's out. This guy's really, really jammed. Yes. So, is it okay if we have two drummers? You'll be the lead drummer, though. Okay. Get another drummer. What did they open drives? You play drums? Oh, good. And would you rather stand or sit when you play? Okay, no problem. And let's see here. On the count of three, the person I'm touching is going to play a very unusual instrument. Something most of you have never heard of before. I doubt if I would either. One, two, three, up and dry, sir. Understand you play a rather unique instrument, is that right?
You got that.
Oh, good. Come up here, sir. Just that watch cameras. And, sir, do you have a name for this instrument that you play? What do you call this very unique instrument? What do you call it, sir? What is it?
The unique instrument.
I see, yes. Very good name. I think, is this it, sir, right here? Is this it? Oh, good. Put it on the way you normally wear it, sir. This is a relatively new here in the United States. It's been playing down in Australia now for about 7 years, but this is the first time that anyone's ever attempted to play it in the United States. It's been quite a mouthful, sir. Can you blow into it? Is that it? Sir, this might be a hard question to answer with your mouth full, but there's orange and pink and yellow and red. And white. Is there any significance to the different colors? Is that for sound or is this decorative?
That's
okay. See? Decorative. You heard it, people, right here. On the count of three, anyone that does have an instrument is going to sit up, open up your eyes. You don't need backup, do you?
No.
On the count of three, anyone that does have an instrument, sit up, open up your eyes. Realize you have a front row seat for a Madonna concert right here in Spencer, Iowa. If for some reason you haven't enjoyed Madonna's music, you'll be elated to be here tonight. As a matter of fact, each one has won a major radio contest. You get to go backstage and meet Madonna and the band at the end of the show. One, two, three. Open up your eyes, ladies and gentlemen. Madonna. Give her a big hand, people. After Prom 1994, Spencer, Iowa. Yes. All right. Now we're going to do one of your old ones. I like a virgin. Is there any particular key you'd like to have the band play in? It's up to you, but not your gig. What key? Any key?
Yeah.
Which one?
Any
key. Okay. She's still lazy to work with. Must have been a long bus ride. Okay, Madonna, be ready? Be ready. Yes. Ever in the band to put that down? Except for the gentleman here with the very unique instrument. By the way, sir, you better put those tambourines down over there, sir, before you sit down. The big tambourines, sir, sir. Sir, you want to move those tambourines over here? They're huge. Just set them down over there by the camera. That's it. There we go. How much do they weigh?
1,000 pounds.
Oh, I thought so. Yeah, they look huge. Now, sir, I understand in Europe this is extremely expensive, this instrument. If someone wanted to buy it here in the States, about it's probably fairly expensive. How much would they have to pay for it here in the States?
$1 million.
Really? You don't want to set that just anywhere, do you?
What?
You don't want to put that just anywhere, do you?
Oh, no.
No. Sir, underneath your chair, there's a safe. The combination is 38818. 38 to the right, 8 to the left, 18 to the right. Put it in the safe, sir. It'll be secure. Underneath your chair. 38818. Yes. Don't worry, sir. We got to see these two big guys. There's security. They'll watch it. Okay, yes. All right. We have security. All right. 38818. $1 million is okay. You don't want to just send it anywhere. Yes. Seems to be a very flexible instrument. And a rather... rather deep safe. Sir? 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 There's a guy in the back. He repairs these things. Give it to him, he'll repair it. Any instructions?
Very careful.
Yeah. Very careful. Sit back down. Remember, these guys have security, though. Did you lock the safe again? Okay, good. All right, always very important. By the way, Madonna. You know, Madonna, you've traveled all over the world. You play in front of fans and royalty everywhere. What do you think of your fans right here this morning in Spencer Island? What do you think of Madonna?
They're awesome.
Yes, awesome. Give her a big hand, Madonna! Hello, Madonna. You got a big fan down here. Shannon Center, big fan. Do you think you could maybe have a picture taken? Would that be possible? Oh, good. Would you like a picture taken with Madonna, sir?
Yeah.
Oh, good. Sit right up here on the stage, sir. This is going to be great. Madonna, you want him to come up there? Oh, okay. Sit right up here. You going to sit beside him on his lap or what? Whatever, you know, we're going to take pictures of you. But... is your fan? Oh, yes. Well, that is great. Yes. Oh, what a great place to work there. Thank you very much, Madonna. You're good. Yes.
Yes!
Everyone, sit up one more time. Feet flat on the floor, palms on your knees. Watch my hand again as it moves from the ceiling. Yes. You can put your tambourines underneath your chairs, ladies, if you want. Did that hurt your knee at all? Okay. How do you keep it from hurting your knee? You know, it looks like it'd be a brace. Isn't it an abrasive at all?
No, I velcro it on.
Oh, velcro.
There's like padding on this knee.
I see. Oh, very good idea. Yeah, that way you don't scratch your knee if it was tambourines. Okay, everyone, watch my hand one more time. When I drop my hand and say sleep, just allow yourself to drift right back down one more time. 1, 2, 3, sight. Give another big hand, people. Down deep. On the count of three, you sit back up one last time with your eyes closed. You're feeling comfortable. 1, 2, 3. Eyes closed, people. Feeling very comfortable indeed. That's it. And in about, by the way, spiders, you can go back to the audience. Thanks a lot, guys. By the way, people, in about 20 minutes or so, you're going to come out if your nose is feeling great. But at that point in time, most of you up here will not believe that you've been hypnotized. You're going to think you're better just a few brief minutes. Some of you will remember absolutely everything, and yet some of you will remember nothing at all. But a number of things are going to happen when you come out of hypnosis. For instance, I think I will reintroduce a very special young couple who met just a little bit earlier during a major screen test. Not right now, sir, but in a little while. In a little while, sir, when you open up your eyes, sitting on your lap is going to be that beautiful young lady, whispering sweet nothings in your ear. You having eyes only for her, her having eyes only for you. As it just continuing to drift down. And most of you out there probably look upon these as normal, ordinary M&Ms. However, they can be used for many different things. Let me show you what I'm talking about.
Not right now, sir. But in a little while, sir, when you come out of hypnosis, you're going to look down, see what first appears to be M&Ms, but the second time you look down, sir, you're going to realize they're actually very valuable diamonds worth hundreds of thousands of dollars. Now, nobody else here realizes the importance of those diamonds or them being so rare. If, sir, if you can collect those diamonds and put them in your pocket or hand without me catching you, you'll be able to keep those. However, sir, if I catch you, you better have some creative excuse on what you're doing. If I buy the excuse, you'll be able to keep the diamonds. If I don't buy the excuse, you will not be able to keep the diamonds. The other thing touching right here, when you come out of hypnosis, you're going to feel great. Anytime you hear me say the word Iowa, you're going to realize the gentleman on your left has some of the best smelling cologne you've ever experienced in your entire life, which would be absolutely divine in any way. But if you hear me say the word Florida, it's going to be absolutely terrible. If I say Iowa again, it's going to be great. If I say Florida, it's going to be terrible. Gentlemen, touch right here. When you go back to the audience, sir, you're going to very nonchalantly get your open up your safe, take out your instrument worth a cool million. You're going to take that instrument back to the audience, sir. And then for 5 minutes after the show, sir, you'll be the resident expert on that instrument. If anyone were to ask any questions on that instrument, you'll give them an in-depth technical definition, a country of origin, how long it took you to learn how to play, etc. But as soon as you walk away from this area, like out toward the front door, out by the front desk, sir, you're going to realize you're carrying nothing more than a balloon ensemble. Nothing more than a balloon ensemble. You're going to be number one, number two, and number three. Number one, two, and three, anytime you hear me say the word microphone, you're going to realize a jolt of electricity is going to go right through your chair. You have absolutely no idea what caused it, people. You might get up and move around, but you're going to realize a jolt of electricity is going to go through your chair anytime you hear me say the word microphone. Gentlemen, attention right here. I'm going to give you a chance to win $10, sir. All you have to do is answer three rather easy math questions. However, sir, and sleep deep down. However, sir, you will not be able to say the number six. You'll not be able to say the number six until I snap my fingers. Jump my attention right here. When you come out of hypnosis, sir, you're going to continue to speak in the Martian tongue. And you're going to think you're speaking in the English language. You're going to continue speaking in the Martian tongue. Jump my attention right here. When you go back to the answer, you're going to sit down feeling comfortable. The next time you hear me say the word Spencer, sir, you're going to jump up and yell, I wet my pants and I'm proud of it. And then you're going to look around, sir, absolutely no idea why you said that in front of all these nice people. And you certainly won't remember who told you to say it. That's it. Down deep. That's it. Right now, people want each one of you to begin to concentrate on something you want to become better at. Concentrate on that thought right now. For those of you up here are students, people, you will find that your motivation to study during the remainder of the school year will indeed be greater than it's ever been before. Your concentration more intense. Your comprehension more complete. Anything you read or hear, people, you're not only going to be able to retain, but you will be able to recall anytime you want. Easily, effortlessly, automatically. If you're sitting down to take a test, you can't recall an answer, people. All you're going to do is take a deep breath all the way in, hold, and then exhale slowly. We're counting backwards from 5 to 1. On the count of 1, a channel open to the subconscious mind, and it will retrieve that information instantaneously. If it doesn't come back in that second, people, move right along to the next question. If the answer is there, it will be retrieved before the end of the exam. And for those of you who like to break a bad habit, maybe you like to quit smoking or chewing, maybe you like to quit biting your fingernails, maybe you like to quit overeating or overdrinking, listen carefully. You will find from the instant you walk off the stage, people, anytime your hand moves toward your mouth for the purpose of that activity, you'll instantly become consciously aware of what you're doing. You'll stop, you'll look at your hand, and you'll make a conscious determination that you are now the master and no longer the slave of that negative habit of days gone by. And you'll find that sometime between now and next week at this time, you will totally and completely have mastered that habit. Totally and completely have mastered that habit. And for those who are athletes, I want you to concentrate on your given sport. You're going to find that your motivation in that sport will intensify from this day forward. Anytime you walk out on that court, on that field, on that track, on those mats, on that pool table, that dartboard, those bowling lanes, whatever the case might be, people, mentally, emotionally, and physically, you will come together as one. You will utilize 100% of what you're capable of at all times. If you've been taught to do something in a given situation, if that situation presents itself, people, you will do so automatically without even thinking about it. You'll have a great deal of confidence in yourself and your ability to be successful and creative each and every time you compete. On the count of 5, you're going to open your eyes feeling absolutely wonderful in every way, not being embarrassed at all. As a matter of fact, most of you will not believe that you've been hypnotized. You're going to think you've been in just a few brief minutes. Some of you will remember everything, but some of you will remember absolutely nothing. But I'm sure you people will be kind enough to fill in on a few details. I'm sure my dad's going to be wondering about that picture with you. Okay, now, On the count of five, open up your eyes, you will feel great, but remember your post-hypnotic suggestion. For instance, gentlemen, attention right here, when you come out of hypnosis, sir, and look down, you're going to see those M&Ms, and then you're going to realize they're actually very valuable diamonds worth hundreds of thousands of dollars. You're going to start retrieving them almost immediately, sir, but keeping a close eye on me at the same time. Down deep. Deeper still. You're going to be one, two, and three. Down deep. Anytime you ever say the word microphone, you're going to realize that general electricity is going to go right through your chairs, and instantly you'll try to do something about it. Numbers one, two, and three. Down deep. Gentlemen, that's right here. Anytime you ever say the word hypnosis, you're going to realize for some strange reason, your shirt is on backwards. You have absolutely no idea how that came to be, so you'll quickly correct it. Just slip your arms out and turn it around. But each time you ever say the word hypnosis, you're going to realize your shirt is on backwards and have to do something about it. Gentlemen, that's right here. You're going to continue to speak in the Martian tongue until I snap my fingers. You're going to continue to speak in the Martian tongue. Now, attention right here. Anytime you ever say Iowa, the gentleman in your eyes is going to have the world's greatest cologne on. If I say Florida, it's going to be nasty. Iowa great, Florida terrible. When you go back in the audience, so the next time you ever say the word Spencer, one time and one time only, you're going to jump up, yell at my pants, and I'm proud of it. Then you're going to sit down and have absolutely no idea why you said that. Gentlemen, attention right here. You're going to take that instrument back to the audience with you, worth a $250,000. You will be the resident expert, sir, until you move out toward the desk area, and then you're going to realize you're hearing nothing more than a balloon ensemble. You will not be able to say the number six, sir, until I snap my fingers. You'll not be able to say the number six, so you're going to have that beautiful young lady sitting in your lap whispering sweet nothings in your ear. Sweet nothings in your ear. That's it. And the other test right here, the next time you hear me say after prom, you're going to have something extremely important to tell the audience. You're going to jump up, grab the microphone, and immediately forget what it was that you wanted to say when you hear me say after prom. On the count of five, you can open your eyes feeling fantastic after these few brief minutes of hypnotic relaxation. By the way, people, as soon as you walk out the door this morning and take one breath of that air into your lungs and exhale, you're instantly going to be re-energized, revitalized, and motivated, having more than enough energy to do anything you want the remainder of the day. But if you finally decide to go to sleep as soon as your head hits the pillow, you'll fall asleep almost instantaneously, depending on what you want to do the rest of the day. On the count of five, you're going to open up your eyes feeling great after these few brief minutes. One, two, slowly coming back up. Three, four, five. Open up your eyes, people. Take a deep breath all the way in and exhale slowly. Give them a big hand. Didn't they do a great job? Hey. So who's that?
Betty.
She's nice. I'll be back. She's hot.
Tying my shoe.
Really? Is it okay now?
Yeah.
Okay. How you doing, sir? Uh-oh. How you doing?
Alright.
Good, good. I'm just gonna take care of you. How you doing?
Fine.
You, sir?
Great.
Good morning. How you doing?
Great.
Sir, have you ever been to a Madonna concert?
Yeah.
What would you say basically you think about her and her music?
I don't care.
So you'd never try to act like her in front of over 300 people, would you? How'd you do, huh, people? How'd you do? You know, Madonna does have a great number of fans around the country. And you have quite a few fans here. Matter of fact, you have one big fan in the front row here. You had to be there, sir. It was kind of a spur of the moment thing. How you doing?
Good.
And you?
Great.
How long have you been up here? What does it feel like? How many minutes? First thought. Short time? What did you say?
10 minutes.
So should we finish up so we can take on and do other things?
Sure.
Tell you what, people, does it feel like you've been hypnotized? Are you not quite sure? Raise your hands if you're not sure, huh? People, it is now 25 minutes after 4. Which means you've been sitting up here on this stage for over 1 hour. Over 1 hour. What time is it?
Not that terrible.
Okay. On the count of three, most of you will be able to stand up and walk back to the audience. But before they go back, I would like to explain a few things about what you witnessed here tonight, or this morning. What you saw on this stage was a demonstration of hypnosis. Now, different people, sir, look at your shirt. Hypnosis. Yes, different people respond different ways when they're in this state. For instance, the subconscious mind will take a hold and immediately bring about a change in the conscious mind. Now you can use this to take off weight, to quit smoking, to quit chewing, to quit nail biting. You can also use hypnosis to improve in study skills, motivation to study, concentration, memory, athletic enhancement, all of those types of things. And it really makes no difference, people. It makes no difference where I work with hypnosis. For instance, last night, I was down in Florida. But
we don't know how we got up here.
Well, you crawled. Don't worry, it wasn't that bad. It was a long trip, though. Sir, you want your shirts off? Don't worry, we got your shorts back on. Okay, now. No, not really, sir. Not really. Well, it's nice being back here in Iowa. You know, I was in Florida last night, but it's nice being back here in Iowa tonight. The people here in Iowa have a tendency to be great people, and I really appreciate working here in the great state of Iowa because people are always so easygoing. But it was a little bit warmer down in Florida, actually, than it is here. As a matter of fact, it's kind of humid down in Florida. But again, coming back up here to Iowa tonight, it did cool down there just a little bit. By the way, would you like to make $10?
Yeah.
Come here. Tell you what, all you have to do is answer three rather easy math questions without making a mistake, all right? Now, they're going to be rather easy, but take your time so you don't make any real simple mistakes. First question, we're going to do an addition, 7 + 8. Now, take your time, sir. We're going to take 7. We're going to add 8 to it. You're going to be 1/3 of the way there if you get this answer right. What is it?
15.
Good. Okay, 1/3 of the way there. Okay, now we're good. Yes, give a hand, people. There's 1/3 of the way there. 2 more thirds left. Okay, now subtraction, right? Subtraction. 18 minus 11. 18 minus 11, you'll be 2/3 of the way home if you get it. 18 minus 11 is?
7.
Yeah, 7. Okay, all right. Okay, one more. Division. Pretty good at division?
Nope.
Why don't we, I'll make it real easy. 1 divided into 6.
I don't know.
What's 1 divided into 6?
7.
Sounds very easy to the, similar to the English. Tell you what, sir. If you count out loud on your fingers from 1 to 10 without missing a number, I'll let you go. How's that sound?
Sure.
Okay, go ahead. Do it slowly.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
You have 11 fingers? Yeah. Wow, what an interesting development. And now try.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9,
and give him a big hand, it's his bad time. Come back to this time. Now people, when you go back to the audience, it is important that you don't trip over the microphone cord, alright? Yes, don't trip over the cord here. It is rather important that we don't do that. Because the microphone cord sometimes can... Is there a problem? Huh? What's wrong? Really? Are you sure it's okay? How's yours?
Okay.
Okay. Sure. All right. By the way, sir, when I snap my fingers, you're going to realize you're holding a stand. 1, 2, 3. Sir, what is that?
It's my poster.
You think anyone ever kissed one of those?
Have it.
Give a big hand. Nice young man. Well, it was nice being back here tonight in Spencer, or this morning in Spencer. Oh, they cry much of your people. They cry, huh? I was in Chicago the other day, or something like that happened. By the way, sir, what is this? What is it? Is there someone in your chair? Can you trade places with him, sir? Can you trade places? Would that be okay? Maybe it's just his chair. You know what I said? You know what I said? Why don't you just stand over there for just a second and let's see if you can sit. Your chair hasn't been any problem with your chair, has there, sir? There hasn't been any problem with your chair, has there? Nothing. Okay. Sorry, then, sir. His chair's fine. You can slide down there. Yeah, use that one. By the way, you're not going to have to change your shirt around again, right? Now, people, if you'd like to learn more about hypnosis, when you leave here tonight, I'm going to leave some brochures out here by the door. I'll feel free to pick up a brochure and send it to my office. I will send you out a free 4-week self-hypnosis program. It's a step-by-step procedure that teaches you how to work with the power of the mind yourself. So if you wouldn't need people, like to learn more about hypnosis when you leave here tonight, we will have some brochures right out there by the door. Feel free to pick one up when you go. Sorry, DJ, I dropped your microphone. Okay, now, as soon as... Is that your bad too? On the count of three, you will be able to stand and clock back to the audience. 1, 2, 3. Give a big hand as they go back to the audience. Give a big hand as they go back. You ready to get that, sir? Give me this one, will you? Huh? Hey, what are they? Really? Don't show anybody, sir. Just take it. Yeah, don't show anybody. Just put back your hat. Don't show anybody, sir. On the count of three, the diamonds are going to turn into real ice. 1, 2, 3. Sir? Can you sit around and answer a few questions about that? Oh, good. Give him a big hand. If you're just going to sit around and answer a few questions, I should sit right down there, sir. And we do have some pictures of the people who are left up here on stage earlier. They are for sale. No. They're your property. You'll be able to pick them up on your way out. All right? We're going to leave them right here. All right? He's going to be here to answer. People. Didn't they do a great job here? Well, we're going to end it there. Hopefully you had a fantastic night here at your prom. This is about my fourth time I've been here. You're really a fantastic group. Have a great weekend. Thank you, people. Take care. And good night. Thank you. Well, you can pick up one of your pictures. If you want to ask me a question about this, you can have a